Okay, so today is 24th lecture, and let us begin our exercise. So now you have some idea about what is called composite material. Composite materials are materials which are obtained by combining two or more materials into one. So you can have one isotropic, another isotropic, another isotropic also. If you combine them, so what you will get is composite. In fact, steel and aluminium also, they are composite, because there is no material which is isotropic, because steel, there are so many components inside. You have this alloy, that alloy, you know, there are so many. If you see the composition of steel or aluminium, there will be number of smaller constituents which form the your final steel product in the factory. So that way, there is no material which is not composite. But for the sake of our simplicity and at a larger scale, not at micro scale. Micro scale, yes, steel is not composite. Steel is micro level, it is composite. Micro level, it is not composite. But then we are dealing with things, you know, at micro level. So we will consider steel, aluminium, carbon, boron, everything as one single material. Now these are joined together with polymer, with plastic, and they give you a different material. They can also be joined, even you can also strengthen a metal. It is called metal matrix composite. So one is fiber reinforced. See, American spelling, they write F-I-B-E-R, but don't go by this. You write your own fiber, F-I-B-R-E. Fiber means this wires, thin. Fiber reinforced polymer composite. In short, it is also called FRPC, FRPC, fiber reinforced polymer composite, or simply FRC, fiber reinforced composite. This is also polymer is, and then you have polymeric based material. And you have also metal means there is already a homogeneous material, let us say steel. You want to strengthen steel itself in one direction. So steel can be reinforced with fiber, which is stronger fiber, which is, let us say, made of material which is stronger than steel. Because if you draw fine wires, they will always be stronger than the parent material, one is clear, because non-homogeneity disappears, small wire, small diameter, small wire. So if you let us say boron fiber, if you strengthen the steel itself, so it will called metal matrix composite. Then it is called metal matrix. So then the base material is metal. Here the base material is polymer. Then you are getting the base material metal matrix composite. So it is not something, it is called MMC. So metal matrix, and they can also be treated in the same manner. Once you know the mechanics, how to deal with material, whose properties are different in different directions. So this is also will be an orthotropic material, because you are going to strengthen in one direction. Of course, there is a one technology developed in, and it was propagated for some time. See, these are different sheets which are joined together to form the total laminate. Is it not? Number of layers are there, number of sheets are there. So, you know, under load there used to occur this delamination. Many times these sheets used to get delaminated because of shear. There are two modes of failure, either due to shear or due to splitting. Transverse normal stress increases, is more than that of the strength of the gluing material. Okay. So, then this used to happen. So, then they said, why not stitch it just like you stitch a cloth, stitch in the third direction, stitch, but then it is very complicated. It idea was okay, stitching, but stitching is not a practical proposition. Stitch third direction. So, that means they will put a wire here in the third direction also, and let us say, you know, something like you have riveting kind of thing, you know, make a hole and then put it like this. So, it will be at different, but then you are damaging the material. In the process, you are also damaging the material, because the continuous flow of the material is damaged by making the hole which you are doing. So, unless you do fine, and that is not possible in the field. So, because these sheets, so still it is only the thin sheets which are fabricated in the factories, and they are rolled, they come in rolls, and with that roll you make your laminate. Okay. So, you can deal with both metal matrix composite as well as polymer based material or matrix. So, this is transformation. Please read it from the, I have given you the transformation rule. Please see what is, because you have to deal only with what is C matrix. C matrix of the parent material. That means C matrix will be with reference to 1, 2 and 3, 3 directions, principal directions of orthotropic. Then those are transformed with reference to X, Y and Z. So, this is, now this C matrix, one is 3 dimensional, other one is, because you have seen the plate theories have been developed by taking only plane stress condition. So, this also you need not consider the 3 dimension, it can also be just 2 dimension. That means, in the case of, let us say, when we are dealing with Poisson-Kirchhoff theory, then you will take sigma x, sigma y. Sigma z is 0, so that line will go, and similarly you will not be using tau xz and tau yz. So, only 3 lines will be there, out of 6 lines only 3 lines will be there in terms of, so that you know. So, please see now there the number of, I think we had seen last time, how many elastic constants will be there, 5 independent elastic constants for a plane stress condition, E1, E2 and E3, E2, 2 and 3 will be same, E1 will be different, so 2, then G1, 2 and G1, 3 will be same, so and G2, 3 will be different, so 2 G's, so 2 E's, 2 G's and 1 nu. Because other new you can find out from the this one, symmetry rule. So, 5 elastic constants will be needed for a plane stress condition. So, please understand what I am saying, do not remember, try to understand, and then only you will get all these material properties. So, now you can read any book on composite material, because more than 60-70% of the book of any composite material will consist of analysis of plates and shells and beams using these material properties. So, that we have already covered. While classical book of Timoshenko and other, they use only isotropic material. So, other thing I have already told you, thermal. Thermal I have told you what changes. And the third thing that that has come into the picture is your hygrothermal. That means ingress of water into the material, then the material property deteriorates. So, how to take that ingress of water into that effect is similar to temperature. I will not take it in the class, but you please see hygrothermal effect on beams, plates and shells. Hygrothermal effect, ingress of water into the material. Obviously, we all know material property will deteriorate under the action of water ingress. So, what does it do? Yes, it is similar, behavior is similar like temperature. Temperature does what? If you raise the temperature, then it will, the one sphere will remain sphere only, it is isotropic. Sphere, it expands in all directions. So, it is isotropic behavior, just like water pressure. Water also, when it is there, enters, so it expands equally in all the direction. So, there the effect is similar to temperature. So, that effect also can be included in the formulation, hygrothermal. Other material that has come in the of late is called piezoelectric, to control the behavior of any structural system. You have what is called PIEZO, piezo, piezoelectric, means if you change the, if you pass current into the material, then material stress and strain can be changed. Okay, by changing, by passing the current, current will have effect on the stress and strain. That means one more electrical current comes into the picture and you will have a new constitutive relation. Again, I am not taking that into, but piezoelectric material has become very important these days, PIEZO, piezoelectric. You can see some of our papers, we have done some work on this. If you go to the website and see the journals, publication in journals, so there you will find piezoelectric in the last 10 years. So, we have also done some work, we have analyzed number of plates and shells with piezoelectric kind of material. So, it again it is a constitutive relation which will change, nothing else, everything will remain same. Equilibrium, strain displacement, everything will remain the same, boundary condition, everything will remain the same. Only thing is material constitutive relation, because here now one more effect comes, that is electricity, effect of electricity on the stress and strain. So yes, that is where the, you have to study the constitutive relation. So, constitutive relation is not as simple as strain equal to elasticity matrix into stress. Normally we know, and if it is a temperature, then you do, you add alpha T, you will be also having some E means, you have E means small e, they use it for electricity, and what is the effect of that? So that can be included. So this is a piezoelectric, means material constitutive relation. Will change. No other thing will change. So, only thing you please see what is the, where, what is this relationship? Study. It is given in some new books on mechanics of solids, because since this material is new, so it is given in one some modern books on mechanics of solids, not the classical. And then you can see it from our paper, we have, it is there, I do not remember, but certainly some new books are there, it is there. So, this is, you please see. So, now what remains is the various formulation with all these changes. We have done very simple formulation in the class, that is isotropic material. And then plate of different, with different assumptions, we have done it. The same thing can be done by including all this that I have told you so far. last 2 days or 3 days I am telling you, all the formulations will can be derived with new material, with new properties. So that is all is needed for solving any problem in. One is, see, there are three parts to any study. One is theory. Theory is important for any, which theory, what assumptions, that is theory. After knowing the theory, you have to solve the problem, analysis. Analyze a given problem for that particular theory and find out the result. Now, there are two approaches, you already know, you have, no, that is one. In general, analytical method, which we have followed in this course, and the other one is numerical. Why do you go for numerical? No, using of computer, but why do you have to need computers? These are the two approaches for solving any problem, analysis. You tell me, what is the correct answer? In simple language you say, analytical method, we can solve, we can analyze simple problems which are simple in theory, simple in form, and then simple loading, simple boundary condition, everything has to be simple, then only you have got some, because Navier's method, when does Navier method works? Navier method I have explained, I have solved problem using Navier, very popular method for solution of plate problem, any rectangular plate problem, Navier, when boundary conditions are simply supported. In both direction we assume a sine or cosine Fourier series, solution in terms of series, we just assume, let us assume some solution, because the plate anyway under the load will deflect like this curve. So, assume this, not only one term, but number of such terms, and combine such solutions. So, Fourier series, so this is called Fourier analysis, and it has got infinite number of terms. Only thing, good thing about Fourier series is that it is highly convergent. It converges very fast. You do not have to go to 100 terms or something, few terms only will give you 99% correctness. So, convergence is very fast. Then why does convergence is fast in with sine cosine function? This also I have given you, come on. Why it is noted in our analytical method with our experience tells us that convergence of this series is very fast. In fact, W convergence, displacement convergence, you will get in 3 or 4 terms only. Only when it comes to stresses, normal stresses, planar stresses, you will get convergence in 6 or 7 terms. When it comes to transverse stresses, that means the 3 transverse stresses, then it takes about 15 or 16, maybe 20 terms. So, this is the range of rate of convergence slowness. Why it is happens? Why do you get fast convergence? By taking with sine cosine. Why don't you take, instead of sine cosine, you should have taken some other function? Orthogonal was, one is orthogonal property. What is, so orthogonal property is the simplifies, orthogonality simplifies. Simplifies because there is something that you get uncoupling, m and n, if m equal to n, then you get something, and m not equal to n, then you get 0, those terms come. So, it simplifies orthogonality. Other one which I have told you a very important thing, how do you, derivatives, yes, all these functions have infinite derivatives. So, there is no restriction on whatever derivatives comes into your formulation, they can be evaluated exactly. It is not like a plus bx, which has got, you can a plus bx is a linear function. You can have first derivative which you will get b, second derivative you will get 0, third derivative non-existent. So, function is such that derivatives are, so if it is there, third derivative is there in your formulation, then what is the meaning of this function? It has no meaning. So, it is which is not true in the case of sine cosine. So, that is very, you get what is called, so that property we call, we get in such functions, we get what is called complete solution. It is not just a solution, but it is a complete solution. Completeness of solution is ensured if you take orthogonal sine cosine functions. Completeness, okay. Higher derivative, so everything can be evaluated there. No, derivative, that is a different issue. Error comes because here, error has, that is also maybe, yes, a point, but in general that if you are doing is analytical solution, then we are not talking of errors. We are not dealing with analytical solution, we are just analytically we are taking the derivatives, okay. So, analytical methods are suitable for classroom textbook problems, not for practical problems. If material becomes non-isotropic, then you will have difficulty. If material, there is a temperature variation, then more complication. So, again there will be some difficulty. So, numerical methods are general method, and here these are global methods, by the way. These methods are global. Means you treat the entire domain, while these are numerical methods are local, point based. And numerical methods got developed, we transform here in numerical method. We transform the differential, because here we do not see, we keep the differential equation as it is. We try to solve the differential equation, okay, either partial differential equation or the ordinary differential equation, whatever, depending upon what method we are. Here numerical method, because you are dealing with mathematical model differential equation, so we numerically we cannot deal with differential equation. So, we transform this into algebraic equation through some approximation. So, for example, what an approximation? For example, dy, or let us say, is approximated as r y2 minus y1 divided by. How do you do this? X2 minus X1. That means, now we are at a point, if you want to find out here, I take a point, one more point, and then I find out, yes, this is I plus 1, let us say. So, I find out in terms of 2. So, y2 minus y1 divided by this minus this. So, this transforms through approximation, transforms your differential equation system, D system, into algebraic, because once it is only nodal quantities, point quantities. Domain is there, but then domain is divided or is visualized as number of discrete points. So, it will come algebraic equation system. It will give you an algebraic equation. So, you are dealing finally with algebraic equation, and your solution will improve as long as solution improves. In theory, as the delta x, I mean I am treating only in one direction delta x, but it can be delta y also, delta z also, delta as delta x tends to 0. So, as you make this interval or this discretization fine, you will get, so either your in finite difference the two points can come closer, or in finite element the length of the element, this is the length of the element between two nodes, that can be smaller, size of the element can be reduced, then you get convergence. You should get, because ultimately what is the definition of dy by dx? Dy by dx, see, limit tending to 0, exact definition of dy by dx, exact definition, this you should not forget, exact definition of dy by d, see, people forget, this is what is this, this is how we explain this, this is equal to, this is exact, not now saying limit delta x tending to 0, this is the, now we are forgetting this, I have just written approximate. So, we are transforming, while this one is the exact definition, this is how you define what is the meaning of slope at a point P of the tangent to the curve. So, this is why dy by dx is found out, the chord becomes, you know the definition, how it is derived. So that is very important. So, keep all these things in mind. Okay, so now, so these are the two approaches. So, depending upon what kind of, how, if it is simple, then always go for analytical solution. See, there is nothing like analytical, because one is, this is global solution. Global means your solution is valid at each and every point in the domain, total domain. Here, local, you are seeking solution only at point I, okay. It is a point based. So, it is not total. So, there is always be point I plus 1, there is a gap, this delta x. I do not get solution in between. I get either here or here, and that too approximate, while it is not so in first one. But only thing is, it is limited by complexity. So, this numerical method is, now we started with, so what are the analytical methods, that is Navier solution, Navier solution is only for rectangular domain, and then we have to assume that all these boundaries are simply supported, then only it can be used. All these are SS. Now, so first of all, and of course, loading etcetera, forget about it, loading also has to be simple, but then this is, so this is simply supported SS. Now, in order to get rid of one at least boundary condition, we got the next method was Levy solution. Levy came with another solution method. So, these are historical. Levy said, yes, I will give you a method in which, or my method if you use, at least you will have a freedom, you can reduce, you need not have all four boundary conditions simply supported, but have only on two. So, only two are opposite edges are simply supported, rest any boundary condition. But opposite edges have to be simply supported, and the other two opposite edges any boundary conditions. Of course, you have governing differential equation, governing differential equation. So, Levy. So, Levy is better than Navier in one respect, that yes, you can have different this can be clamped, this can be free, you know, at least you are able to get this. But here also there is a limitation of loading. Loading cannot be very general. The moment here I have any singular load, like a line load or a point load, then the convergence etc. is a real problem. Okay, it can be, it can take 200, 500 terms to converge for that load. So, both these methods. So, then we have what is called semi-analytical. These are pure analytical. Semi-analytical. Now, what are semi-analytical methods? Semi-analytical says, can we improve this situation? This restrictive situation can be, can this be improved? Yes. So, semi-analytical, one of the methods under semi-analytical is, if you can, plate problem is a two-dimensional problem. We are not dealing with three-dimensional problem. Once you have a plate formulation is any plate, plate formulation is a two-dimensional, it is a 2D formulation. You have only two-dimension independent, not third. Third has already been got rid of. Thickness etc. has gone into moment, shears etc. So, everything is only, is two dimension. Now, if you can transform this problem into one dimension, transform 2D, plate problem into 1D problem. What do you mean by 1D problem? Yes. Yes. So, semi-analytical, so it is similar to, I mean, first you have to master this Levy solution. It is similar to this. So, if I have in a plate, on the two edges, if you assume that this is, I don't assume solution in all the four direct, all the two direction, I assume solution only in this. So, then I can say that yes, in this direction my, in general the solution can be taken as sinusoidal, a combination of sinusoidal. So, I can use Fourier series in one direction. Other direction, because in general it will not be sinusoidal, it will be something else, but we are making an assumption. Yes, if it is like this and if it is normally loaded, then not that in the center maximum amplitude will occur, but it will have the same pattern. That is all we are saying, only pattern will be sinusoidal, need not be symmetrical sinusoidal. Other direction, it can be anything. This, any. So, transform this, and one of the methods is transform this, and then there we developed a method. Actually, we did not develop, it was developed already, but only thing we formalized way back in 1981. This one is there, numerical integration of linear boundary value problem in solid mechanics, and then we have added this segmentation method that will come little later for some reason. I will tell you what is the reason, what is segmentation method. So, you can note down the reference, it is available on the website and you can download also. Okay. So, this is, this describes how to deal with this. Once you can transform this into one dimension, then we have a very good method for solving this numerically. So, one direction analytical assume, other direction we are using numerical. So, I am transforming my partial differential equation into ordinary differential equation of a particular type. This is ordinary differential, y can be any vector, this y is a vector of dependent variable, that will be, and then this load, this will be the general form will be like this. And this, if you have in this form, then this method we have described here, and we have also given the solution methodology and computer program here. Computer program also is there. In those days, I used to do only Fortran programming. This was our method of developing the logic. So, all these things are given here, including the listing of the program here, with explanation of all the description of variable, it is also there. And then this is the listing. See, all this Fortran segment listing, this is the one subroutine. All this listing is given here, okay, some input, etc. Anyway, so this is a very important, we consider it is very important for one reason, because many problems can be now tackled. And I can have generality in my this direction, although one direction is restrictive, because paper name, numerical integration of linear boundary value problems in solid mechanics, it is valid for any, not necessarily plates, any, it is also valid for fluid mechanics, by the way, because I, when I wrote, I did not have idea, let me tell you, because I was dealing only with solid mechanics. So, even in fluid mechanics and soil mechanics, any partial difference, it is valid for any partial differential equation. You reduce the dimension by some means, we have taken it, okay. Assume solution in one direction, assume. So, you have assumption in one, other direction you have left it free, and that you integrate numerically. So, integration of ordinary difference, we are not transforming this into algebraic equation, because ordinary differential equation integrators are available, very good integrators are available. So, integrate in this one. So, this is, please see this and see this paper, and that will help you to tackle many problems. I think I have also discussed this in the last course. So, this is like this. So, now let us take the next paper as a consequence of that is this. Now, you will say that why I am taking only our paper, not other. Anyway, first person is always more important than first person. What is most important thing in life? First person, self. So, because here I have got confidence, because we have done it with our own. Okay. So, you know everything what you have done. Okay, so this is numerical analysis of elastic plates with two opposite simply supported ends. Only thing, condition is two opposite edges simply supported, rest is we have kept it general, and this we have used, we have tried to explain this with a reference to Poisson-Kirchhoff theory, because the method was there. So, in those days I was not dealing with composite material, so it is only with isotropic. But different boundary conditions have been tackled here. On this side, different boundary conditions, and there are number of good solutions that we obtained, and we showed it here. So, please read this paper and practice it. How it has been, formulation is all there. Now, I will explain this formulation. Just I will take, so for example, first one, now same thing, so this is with the simplest theory. Then I graduated, I said let us use it with also for Mindlin. How? So, Mindlin theory is this, this appeared in, this is 83, this one, this appeared in which year? This is 81, computers and structures, that is computers and structures volume 14, page number 195 to 203 in 1981, this is there. Now, this appeared in 1983, volume number 109, AC Journal of Engineering Mechanics. So, this is the same thing using Mindlin theory, Mindlin formulation for plate. Okay. So, this is with plate, and Mindlin has certain advantages which we could see. One is, what is the most important advantage of Mindlin? There is no confusion about boundary condition when it comes to, so you do not have to define a fictitious Kirchhoff shear Vx in order to resolve this problem of free boundary condition. While of course, here the differential equation order changes, here it becomes how much, fourth order, here it becomes sixth order. So, three boundary conditions on each automatically comes for all the cases and everything is perfect and plus in a simplistic way you are able to take also here shear energy is included while here it is not shear energy. So, this is not valid for any composite material, let me tell you. So, all the books that give you theory of composite plates using this theory, they are all useless. Okay, they were written just application, blind application of this theory for composite without realizing that composite material must include shear energy. You cannot have any composite material, especially polymer composite material, without shear energy. Okay, but 90% books are using only this theory and blindly you solve problems with this. So, it is a blind application. So, this one at least, this open door for shear energy and so this also, and then next, so this one you have noted down, so this also you please read all the three, and all the three are for isotropic material. So, they are simple in application. So, and the third one is this, it was very difficult to publish in this in those days, and but then this is I have given here, and this actually, this is the one which opened the door for higher order. There were no papers before this 1982. So, I am credited with this, you have started this for this kind of work. So, although the title is very simple, again, because I thought that let us, you are doing a great job by saying thick plate. Thick plate means it will include all the effects, do not have to neglect anything. So, here we have used higher order theory to analyze a thick plate using, but then the same thing can be extended to all composite layered anything. So, this is in computer methods in applied mechanics and engineering, this is in volume 31 pages 1 to 18. So, this is, you please see, so this one does based upon this, you have added this term and then we have given the solution. Of course, we have compared with a 3D solution and we have shown. So, anyway, these are the three four papers that I have shown you. So, this one gives you this, all these techniques I will call it semi analytical. Why semi analytical? Because in one direction I am using analytical function which satisfies the boundary condition exactly. In one direction, other direction I will satisfy the boundary condition numerically, boundary condition I will satisfy exactly, but then there are few other issues as you will go deeper into it where we are making making any approximation. So, but then it gives you very good solution method. So, this is applicable for beam, plate, cells, arch, anything. So, this you please read, okay, we will just have a break for 5 minutes.